The 18th century was a period of great turmoil in the Indian subcontinent. Though the century opened with much of subcontinent under the control of Mughal Empire, the death of Emperor Aurangzeb in 1707 resulted in fracturing of the empire and created a struggle among viceroys and other local rulers for the territory. In the 1740s and 1750s, French and British colonial companies became more active in these local conflicts. The British had their strong base at Madras. The present-day Karnataka region was split into many kingdoms. The northeastern parts were under the control of Hyderabad Nizams. The northwestern parts were under the control of the Marathas. The southern parts were under the British, and a portion in central and southern parts were under the control of Wadayars. Each of these powers fought with and against others and sought to draw the power of French and British colonial companies to serve their objectives. Whereas the colonial powers saw this opportunity to influence the local powers to gain either direct control of territory or the revenues from the territory. Around the same time, the Mysore kingdom under Wadayars was slowly took over by Hyder Ali. He joined Mysore army as a soldier. Within a few years, he became the commander or Dalwai in the army. Soon his influence grew and he became the chief minister of Mysore state. He started ruling on behalf of Wadayar kings. Finally, in 1761, he announced himself as the de facto ruler of Mysore state. The Hyderabad Nizams and the Marathas were concerned over the expansionist threat posed by Hyder Ali. They formed alliances with British to help them in eliminating the threat. The war began in January 1767 when Marathas invaded northern Mysore. They reached as far south as Tungabhadra River before Hyder entered into negotiations to end the invasion with exchange for payments of 30 lakh rupees. The Marathas agreed to withdraw north of the Krishna River. The Nizam on the other hand started to attack from the northeast and advanced to Bangalore accompanied by two battalions of company troops under Colonel Joseph Smith. But Hyder Ali, with his clever diplomatic tactics, negotiated an alliance with Nizams. The deal stuck between two powers made them unite against the British. Hyder was to pay 18 lakh rupees for the invasion to end. After the intelligent diplomatic moves to turn Marathas and Nizamas away from Mysore, Hyder Ali started an offensive campaign against the British, conquering many provinces belonging to them in southern parts. The war went on like this, with Hyder Ali winning few provinces and British striking back to secure them for almost 18 months. Hyder then raised additional forces in Mysore and went on to be very offensive. In November 1768, he split his army into two, regaining control of many minor posts held by British. Hyder then surprised British authorities by taking a force of 6,000 cavalry and a small number of infantry and made a 3-day march of 210 kilometers to the gate of Madras. This show of force compelled the company to negotiate further, since Madras had been left nearly defenseless as the military movements were made to counter the Hyder's main force. Following complete chaos and panic at Madras, English were forced to conclude a very humiliating treaty with Hyder. On April 4, 1769, Treaty of Madras was signed, which brought an end to the war. The treaty had this: the conquered territories to be restored to each other and that they would help each other in case of any foreign attack. This is all about the very first Anglo-Mysore War. In total, there were four Anglo-Mysore Wars, and everything ended in 1799 with the fall of Tipu Sultan, the son of Hyder Ali.